the Atlantic Ocean. Landed about 20 minutes ago. Here now. Gonna do some game planning. Right now we're discussing, we're going over the plan of how we're gonna catch these fish tomorrow, but it should just be so much fun. I'm so pumped. I mean, I'm fishing for a fish I've never caught before. An area I've barely ever fished, so it's gonna be a lot of new work for me. I'm excited though. It's light out enough. I think I can start narrating. So letting you guys know what's going on. As you may be able to tell, I'm not in Illinois anymore. This is quite a different scenery than back home in the Midwest. Kind of wanted to skip all the vlogging BS just for this video. I know you guys like the vlogs, but the beginning of the video was kind of setting you guys up for what's gonna happen. But right now is when we really wanna kind of focus on the filming. Oh, this is so much fun. I haven't even caught a fish yet and I'm like having a blast. How's it going? Are you guys done on the point?
Yeah.
Are you done?
Thank you.
That guy down there said there was a fish in front of him that had a piece of bait so big in its mouth it couldn't even swim. It was like he said it was close to 35 pounds. Oh, it was just behind me. Gotcha, yeah. Let's see. I'm on.
There we go.
Ooh. Wow. Oh, nothing feels better than that. I don't know if it's massive, but it feels good. Finally hooked up to my first one. Oh boy, this feels so good. Yeah, wow, look at that. Doubled up. Yeah.
Look at that. Oh my god, these fish are heavy.
Look at that brute. That is a nice fish. Gorgeous, gorgeous. First ever start. I can barely even fit in the frame. Look at that. Okay, here we go. Going for the release. We moving? Get in there. Go strike. What are you doing? Okay, there we go. Much better release. Got the foot wet too. Yeah, the crazy thing about this is John and I came out here like crack ass at dawn, like super early. It was still dark. Could barely even film. Everyone was out here. I mean, the bank was littered with anglers and people were catching them at dark. But the thing is, it's like, it's a weekday, people have work. There's like a pretty high amount of anglers here that are just fishing for dinner. So most of these people have a one fish limit. They catch one and they're gone. Like, that's it. We start off like elbow to elbow to these anglers and all of a sudden we're the only ones on the strip. It's pretty insane. Hopefully these fish are still biting. I mean, I think they are. Oh, I feel so good to get my first ever striper under my belt. That was just such an epic feeling. Like everything happened at once. Like, I hooked up, he hooked up, people around me were hooking up. It was so beautiful. It was just a magical moment. We're sitting a bit idle right now. It's cleared out. It's crazy this morning. It was like a circus. People shoulder to shoulder, drags peeling nonstop. It was like unlike anything I've ever seen before. I did not expect this. I came out here thinking that, you know, there's gonna be a lot of anglers. Few guys hooking up, but I think everyone we passed, someone was either hooked up or already had a fish. Well, I mean, this is the first time I've ever fished out here before. Missed three fish, caught my first ever striper, and it was like a quality fish too. But yeah, it's gotten so quiet you can literally hear the crickets chirping now. We're kind of waiting for this tide to really fully switch. It just now turned. First it was incoming, I think now it's outgoing. So it's switched directions. The tide was going this way earlier, now it's going, let's see, yeah, that way. So we just need to wait until this tide really picks up speed. We're hoping to find some more mackerel too. These fish are really chomping on the mackerel, which is what this thing is right here. And every now and then you'll see them swim by your feet. But for the past hour, 2 hours or so, haven't seen a single pod or school of mackerel, which means the stripers aren't on the prowl. If all goes as planned, if these mackerel finally show themselves, you know, we're really relying on the mackerel and the tide to kind of call the shots right now. But I'm gonna pick up that swim bait, sling a few more casts and finish this muffin. Hopefully another striper will peel some drag here shortly. This is the second spot we've been to. We just drove to the other side of the canal. We basically went to the complete opposite side of the other end of the canal, and there's a lot of hardcore guys here, but no action. Who knows? There's no bait. There's no bait. There's no fish. No luck. Swim bait's topwater, nothing. It's dead. Dead as a doornail. All right, last minute striper, come on. That'd be so sweet.
We don't need much.
Just one. This is our last spot, our last resort. Jumped over to like three other areas, nothing. We just saw this one guy hook up and we're gonna see if there's some bait over there. Hopefully there is. He's still fighting that fish. No way. Come on, please be there's some bait over here. I just wanna go down to that water's edge and see mackerel. That's really what I wanna see. I'm like freaking out.
Come on.
You see that? That was awesome. That was badass.
They're going right now. They're going. What is going on?
I'm hooked up. I thought I was throwing a topwater bait and I just was burning this thing in. First topwater strike of the day. It's a decent one too. It's thrashing. Dude, look how he ate that. Just gone, down the gullet. I did not see how big that fish was until we got him.
Yep. That.
I'm not gonna grab his
without
face.
This, it's like death.
Just that thrash right there, if you had your hand in his mouth.
You saw how crazy that was.
Look at that beautiful fish on top water too. Can you beat that?
Nope.
Look at that brute. That is a toad. Okay, John's filming for me right now, but this is an absolute stud. Probably, what do you think? The biggest one for me of the day, right?
Yeah.
Unreal, and it hit on the surface too. I didn't think we were gonna catch another one today. I legit did not think so. Okay, I gotta put him back in the water without breaking my ankles here. Going for the release. I legit did not think we were gonna catch another one today. We were pulling down here. John literally just wanted to check one more spot. He's like, I just wonder how it looks. We drop down there, turn to our right, and we see like a rod bent. We're like, okay, maybe this is decent. We get a little bit closer and these guys behind us are just destroying them. We pulled up, you know, about 50 yards to their left and started throwing the top water and they're just on. They're eating surface. They're not like busting right now, but they're eating on top. It's such a weird thing. You wouldn't think they'd be crunching the poppers, but they're there. That one ate a giant subsurface walker and it was just such an epic take. Gonna get back out there though. I don't want to do any more talking. This could be really good. We'll see. What the? Oh, here we go. This is what these fish are eating. Little mackerel. He doesn't like that I hooked him. He's a little antsy. So I thought this was a topwater. So I was like getting pissed. I was like, why isn't this thing going on the surface? I was working it to the point where it was on the surface. And that's when he ate it, as soon as it came up to the surface. These guys to our right, they hook up every single cast. We don't see any bait. We're not seeing them surface, but they're out there and they're just pissed off and hungry. So when they start eating like this, it's just your knees start trembling. You're on. I'm ready for it. Turn it on, let's go. I know, I'm on, double. That's a good fish. Just like that last one, I saw the strike and just, oh my God. This is by far the best way to catch them. They're eating in the same area. They're super predictable right now. I'm so glad we didn't just send it in. Like, I'm so glad we looked at, yeah. Hooked up right now, going for a different angle. I think we almost like packed it in and called it a day. It's just hard to believe. I'm so glad we stuck it out. These are nice striped bass. I mean, I don't know if you guys are aware, but these are quality fish, and they get bigger, and that's what we're after right now. There he goes. Gone. Big old brute. I'm on.
Look at that.
All right, there's a mackerel eater for sure. Oh, just crank the swim bait. No question. I don't know, this may be my bigger one of the day. I don't know about the biggest, but yeah, much better, no doubt.
Look at that.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. It's hard to tell.
Are you kidding me? This is a joke. Not only are we catching fish this big, but we're catching them on giant swim baits in top water.
What the hell? Absolute brute. The head on these things is just ridiculous, man. They're such pretty fish too. That's the reason why we're after them. They're strong, fight hard, and they eat lures that are so much fun to throw. I mean, that is a stud. Are they bust? Oh my God. All right, I'm gonna put this guy back. They're freaking just foaming everywhere. Are they in front of us? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, look at this, you guys. There's like a school of striper right in front of where I'm about to put this one back. I am losing my mind. Look at all that mackerel. Holy sh**. That is... Oh, I got a ton. I don't know if you saw that, but that was a freaking striper that just murked a mackerel. This feels decent. Come on, get in here. This thing is pulling. Like, no joke, this one feels probably like my best one. Unless he's just wacky rigged, I don't know. Oh, that's a good one. All right. Awesome. You mind just holding my phone as I put this guy back? Thank you so much. Wow, look at this. Definitely the biggest fish of the day. What's your name?
Brennan
and his buddies let me slide into their spot. They have just been murdering. 70, you caught 75 fish today?
Best day of my life.
These guys are murdering him right now. Unbelievable. I'm going to get a release on this fish. Then see if we can get a treble hook out of a hand. I don't know. This has just been an unreal day. Wow, dude, that's a long fish. Gone. Thank you so much. That's badass, man.
Yeah.
Boom.
That was awesome.
I can't believe it. Here, let me see.
Yeah, I don't know. Every okay. time I've done it, I'm a pussy and go get it taken out.
Well, first of all, you have your tetanus shot? That's a rusty fucking hook. Huh? What you usually want to do is push down on that so that the barb is coming up. Wrap that with braid. Yeah, push down on that. Someone's got to push down on that. Wrap that with braid at least like 5 times. 1, 2, 3 and you rip it. I've done it on this finger before, but it was not a big hook like that. It was a rebar, but it wasn't like that. I mean, if you want to try it, it works. Like, it works, but I've just never done it with a big hook. Don't do that. You'll f*** yourself up. Yeah, don't do that. Yeah, don't do that. You got to, I know for a fact you have to push that down, like, hard, because that barb then repositions. Yeah, no, you just push that down your thumb. No, you're good. You're good. Someone would just hold it like that.
Line around the bend and pop it.
Rip it around and then pop it. Or you go to the ER and they put you on, they give you anesthetic and then...
They cut it out,
which is a bitch too. Either way, it's a bitch. I mean, I can try to pull it out for you, but I can't guarantee it's gonna come out. Yeah, ER, quick, one and done. Probably still be busting when you get back. If someone else here has done the line trick before, I feel like I'd be more comfortable to do it, but I don't wanna, I don't know the guy. I mean, what more could you ask for here? Like, they're crushing top water, they're crushing swim baits. They're big. Oh, there we go, on again. Come here. Oh, son of... Oh, he's still on. What was that? Oh, God. This fish is kind of pissed off right now. I don't think he likes me. He doesn't like that he's got a 12-inch swim bait in his jowl. Oh, man. How big is he? Another nice one. Look at the size of this fish. I can't even, like, I'm just so done with footage. Like, I just, it's nonstop. It's just nonstop. What? Are they crunching? Big fish? This has got to be your best day out here, right?
Oh, this is bigger than that day. This is bigger than that day.
You hear what they said?
What?
They're on 80 fish today. Yeah, my hooks on this bait are just bent. Just, it's toast. Fish are all power. Here we go, gonna switch up baits. Gonna throw this sluggo. This thing is crazy looking. Big old eel looking worm thing. There we go.
That was a vicious strike. This is pure insanity. I caught this thing on a topwater sluggo. What the hell, man? See, bub? Thank you. Well, they're back, that's for sure. They're back. Look at this, guys. There are mackerel teeming in front of our face. Trying to go and eat the sluggo. Oh, he missed it. He's got it. Oh! There we go. There we go. There we go. That was really cool. You know, it's crazy when you're saying fish that big is a rat. Like, we're just... Yeah, I got it. Fish on over there. Got a little rat in my hand. Going back. Can't wrap my head around it. I don't know what to say. I gotta sit down. Let's sit down, guys. This is just too much for me to process. So this is how the story began. I basically booked a ticket to Logan International Airport in downtown Boston about 4 or 5 days ago. Was told that the striper bite's really good here. Linked up with John, who was basically like my guide for today. And never caught a striper before, never held a striper, never seen one in person. And had probably one of the most bang up days of fishing in general in my entire life. Like, that was just pure amazing. That was just so cool. I will never forget this day, period. Like, I'm probably gonna tell this day to my kids, you know, when I'm sharing old fishing stories and I'm like an old crusty dude. This day will be the day that I talk about when I'm 80 years old. I can't explain or put today in words other than the fact that I'm tired, I'm sore, but I'm so happy. And I'm so just fortunate to be able to get in this water. It's crazy too, because Brendan, the guy that let me slide into his spot, slip into his area there, he was telling me on Saturday, which was just 3 days ago, they fished for about like 12 hours, even more maybe, and caught 3 fish that were the size of like a small cat. Like, these fish weren't big. Meanwhile, I come out here and I catch 2 fish that were probably pushing 25 pounds on topwater and swim baits. I think I'm gonna wrap it up here. Thank you guys for watching. I will catch you guys next time. Stay tuned for part 2. And as always, keep fishing. Never stop.